In this video, I'll demonstrate how to create a new grid based on an existing field in a LANDFIRE existing vegetation type grid attribute table. I'll be working in ArcGIS 10, but a similar process can be used in other versions of Arc. There are a variety of reasons why you might want to create a new grid from an existing field. LANDFIRE vegetation grids in particular come with several levels of classification, and you may want to create a grid based on one of the secondary attributes in the table. You can see in the value attribute table from the existing vegetation type grid that I have open here that there are 6 different existing vegetation types, but some of them are quite similar. For example, the first 2 are variants of a Douglas fir hemlock forest. You can see that these are both classified by the same system group name and system group number. Likewise, LANDFIRE mapped 2 similar hemlock silver fir forest types that are both classified by the same system group name and number. I'm going to simplify the types in this grid by creating a new grid based on the system group name field. This will reduce the number of vegetation types in the grid from 6 to 4. To do that, open up the Arc Toolbox Spatial Analyst Tools, then select the Reclass menu and the Lookup command. Drag and drop the existing vegetation type grid into the input raster field. Then, from the lookup field drop-down, select the system group name. Check the output raster location and click OK. At the bottom of the screen, you will see a message that the lookup command is working and the new grid will be added to the project table of contents when it is complete. Opening the new value attribute table, you can see that a unique value was assigned to each name in the system group name field, and the number of types in the existing vegetation type grid has been effectively reduced. You may want to use the join function to rejoin some of the original attributes back to the table, such as the system group number.